So good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to the 9th EU Non-Proliferation and Disarmament Conference. My name is Ettore Greco. I am the Executive Vice President of the International Affairs Institute, which is in charge of organizing this annual event. I'm very pleased to open today's meeting on behalf of the EU Non-Proliferation and Disarmament Consortium. The consortium is composed of other 5 EU study centers: Fondation pour la Recherche Stratégique of Paris, the Peace Research Institute of Frankfurt, the ISS of London, the Vienna Center for Disarmament and Non-Proliferation, and CIPRI of Stockholm, which is responsible for the overall coordination of the project. A central task of the consortium is to promote and coordinate a network of European think tanks, which has been expanded in the last few years and now includes 100 members. The network represents a larger part of the available independent expertise in the field of arms control and disarmament, but also, more broadly, strategic studies. The network and the consortium were established through a decision of the EU Council, and we are now in the last year of the project third cycle. Our mandate is quite comprehensive. It covers all major issues and dimensions of non-proliferation and disarmament, non-proliferation of weapons of mass destruction and their delivery systems, all aspects of disarmament, conventional weapons, small arms and light weapons, and space security. The spectrum of activities we conduct is also rather broad: publications, expert seminars, consultative meetings, training and educational activities, and some specific outreach and awareness raising initiatives. We are currently making an effort to improve those activities on various fronts. We are placing particularly greater emphasis on crucial issues such as the involvement of next generation people, the role of female experts, the synergies that can be established between the existing educational activities in Europe. We have recently published a paper mapping out those activities and organized also an ad hoc expert meeting on this subject of the educational activities. And also the cooperation between the expert community and civil society organizations. For further information on our activity, let me invite all of you to go to our website, which, by the way, our colleagues of the FRS have recently refurbished. The other key instrument we use to inform about the initiative of the consortium and the network is our monthly newsletter, which also I would like to encourage you to read. Our activity is mostly centered on research, but also includes a distinctive policy-oriented dimension. The purpose of the consortium is indeed also to promote a strategic discussion between researchers, practitioners, representatives of government and international organizations on new ways and means to combat proliferation and promote disarmament in light of the emerging global security challenges. In this context, we make a constant effort to promote and enlarge the debate on the EU non-proliferation and disarmament strategy, on its objectives, state of implementation, possible further development and adjustment to the evolving security situation. This international conference in particular is meant to be a key venue for promoting such strategic discussion. A distinctive feature of this conference is the involvement of experts and officials from non-EU countries. As you know, the Union is indeed interested in promoting a comprehensive dialogue with third countries' experts on its action in the field of non-proliferation and disarmament. Let me stress that in organizing this conference, we have, of course, benefited from the crucial support from the European External Action Service and European Commission, that I would like to thank on behalf of the consortium for their very precious advice and encouragement. For all its activities, the consortium receives constant inputs and suggestions from the EU institutions. And we will be able shortly to listen directly from the High Representative Josep Borrell, under whose ultimate guidance we carry out our work, the non-proliferation and disarmament priorities that the EU is pursuing. A key aspect of EU action in the arms control field is, as you know, the cooperation with international organizations, including in particular the EU UN agencies, to which the Union offers valuable financial support and assistance. We have the great privilege to have with us today Izumi Nakamitsu, under UN Under Secretary General and High Representative for Disarmament Affairs, with whom we will have the opportunity to discuss the evolution of the global arms control agenda and the EU-UN cooperation. As you have seen from the conference agenda, we have tried to identify and select a set of topical issues which are at the center of the current debate, both within the EU and at the global level. The leitmotif, the overarching question, if I would identify one, is how to restore the needed trust and confidence in the arms control process that have been dealt serious blows in recent times. Mutual trust and confidence are indeed in short supply nowadays. The overall arms control architecture is under threat, and key arms control agreements such as the INF Treaty have collapsed or have been substantially weakened. Technological advances are also putting new pressures on arms control regimes and raised growing concerns about new escalation risks. The global nuclear order in particular appears much more unstable than in the past due to both persistent proliferation drives, the stalemate on nuclear disarmament, coupled with the development of new nuclear weapons. The EU is, of course, keen on forming broad coalitions to deal with proliferation issues and has continuously confirmed its commitment to the JCPOA with Iran in the hope that the US can revise its position. But from a European perspective, it's also essential that a meaningful dialogue resumes between US and Russia in nuclear arms control. The window of opportunity that has recently opened for the extension of New START Treaty provides, I would say, a significant glimmer of hope in this regard. A successful NPT review conference, which is now scheduled for August next year, would be, of course, key to restoring a climate of trust and confidence. I think it would be interesting to discuss what actual chances we have to exploit the coming months to effectively address and overcome at least some of the major obstacles that risk to prevent a positive outcome of the NPT conference. This afternoon, we will have the great opportunity to discuss this issue with Gustavo Slovinen, President Designate of the NPT Review Conference. In the chemical field, the EU has been at forefront in denouncing the violation of the CWC commitments and the mounting challenges to the CWC regime is certainly a litmus test of the capacity of the international community to preserve the global arms control architecture. On this subject, we will have the pleasure to be briefed tomorrow by Fernando Arias, Director General of the Organization for the Prohibition of Chemical Weapons. Technological advances represent an additional major challenge. We have seen some progress in the global debate on how to regulate lethal autonomous weapons. The intra-European discussion on the matter has also deepened. There remain, however, substantial obstacles to a convergence on the application of international humanitarian law to laws. The key question is if there is room for further progress in this field and in which direction. The EU, as you know, has adopted a ad hoc strategy on arms control and light weapons and is strongly committed to the regime established with the Arms Trade Treaty. As in previous conferences, we will have a session on arms diversion and implementation of the ITT, in which, in particular, we want to discuss how the EU can improve transparency in this field and what new initiative it can undertake to achieve a greater convergence in arms control regulation among member states, and also, based on that, enhance the role that the EU can play in promoting responsible arms trade at the global level. Finally, we will have a session devoted to the impact of the COVID-19 epidemic on arms control processes, and more specifically to biological arms control. This is a subject that the consortium has recently discussed in several expert meetings, including a network meeting that took place 3 days ago. We are in particular concentrating on the lessons that we can be drawn from the experience of the pandemic to enhance biosecurity. So let me thank again all of you for joining us. I'm sure this conference will contribute significantly to the advancement of the European strategic debate, and I very much look forward to our discussion. We have now two opening speeches. First of all, a video message by Josep Borrell, High Representative of the Union for Foreign Affairs and Security Policy.
Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, it's a pleasure to welcome you to the 9th Annual European Union Non-Proliferation and Disarmament Conference. The current barriers to international travel and meetings impose a clear limitation to our diplomatic handwork, but yet multilateralism cannot be at standstill. Now more than ever, we need to reach out to our partners and strengthen our diplomatic ties, looking for the common ground to build lasting solutions for a peaceful and stable future. This is particularly relevant at a time of increased geopolitical competition and global uncertainty over arms control, be it chemical, nuclear, or conventional weapons. The recent and worrisome uses of chemical weapons are a case in point. The well-established norm against chemical weapons must be respected globally, and those who violate it must be held accountable for their actions. As a supporter of the Organization for the Prohibition of Chemical Weapons, the European Union has full confidence in its objectivity, impartiality, and independence. And when it comes to nuclear proliferation, upholding and preserving the Non-Proliferation Treaty remains a key priority of European Union foreign policy, and we strongly support the three pillars of the treaty: non-proliferation, nuclear disarmament, and peaceful uses of nuclear energy. The upcoming Non-Proliferation Treaty Review Conference will be a unique opportunity to reaffirm the value of this instrument and the need for all state parties to comply with it. We are actively working to prepare for this important meeting next year, including by supporting regional and thematic conferences. Through intensive diplomatic engagement, backed up by European Union-funded projects, we are promoting the various instruments of the non-proliferation and disarmament architecture. And we remain fully committed to the Iran nuclear deal the Joint Comprehensive Plan of Action. Efforts must be redoubled to uphold international norms, to restore dialogue and trust, and to promote transparency and confidence-building measures. This also goes for conventional weapons, which account for over 500,000 deaths each year. 500,000 deaths each year. This is by far the largest number of casualties of armed violence. And to counter the diversion of arms and ensure safe stockpiling, the European Union has many instruments in place, including strict export controls and increased transparency measures. Last month, the European External Action Service launched an online database on its website that allows everyone to consult and analyze the data on member states' arm exports in a user-friendly manner. We call on others and other exporters to follow this example and to share data on their exports as well. This is not only a direct contribution to peace and stability, it's also a confidence-building measure and a way to scrutinize and hold authorities to be accountable. Ladies and gentlemen, we must avoid entering into a new arms race, whether nuclear, conventional, or involving new technologies. Unilateral steps and increased secrecy on arms proliferation endanger the peaceful future of the world. At times when the global non-proliferation architecture is under pressure, we must strive to preserve and to strengthen it. And that's why we welcome the important role of the United Nations in this regard, and we will continue to cooperate closely with them. And it's why we call on the US and Russia to extend the New START Treaty before it expires in February 2021. We also encourage negotiations for a broader future agreements. In all these areas, dialogue with our global partners is of essence to rebuild mutual trust in armed control, non-proliferation and disarmament. Thank you for your work, and I wish you a fruitful and open discussion.
So I think the High Representative has already set the stage for our discussion by emphasizing some key security challenges and also give us a sense of the priorities that the EU is pursuing. Let me stress that he has particularly emphasized the cooperation with the UN, and now I have the great pleasure to give the floor to Izumi Nakamitsu, the National Undersecretary General and High Representative for Disarmament Affairs. Please, you have the floor.